The DVD's been there, I mean, video's been there.
Right.
What you had was a little period of a double whammy of VHS and DVD.
Yeah.
And then what falsified the numbers and protected people to a large extent wasn't the continued growth of DVD as much as it was the just proliferation of the market so that you could dump your whole library. So the individual numbers were going down, but people started flooding the market. You know, we brought out, you know, a lot of TV shows, and then everybody's TV show in history has now been released into the market. So.
And was that protective? I mean, inside a studio, inside an organization like that, do you realize, you know, do they spread it out and go, okay, well, you're doing okay on the movie side, not so well on the TV, or better on the TV side? And
no, I think the studios are mismanaged. I don't think the upper management pays attention, understands what's going on. They just look at the bottom line and say, oh, there's a, you know, there's a, in the studio management, there's a big lump sum out of video. Mm-hmm. So are we managing that properly? I don't think anybody has the faintest clue about. And then from the corporate perspective, is the studio making money? Great. They're not looking at, well, how are you making money?
That's interesting to me, because I find it fascinating that people who are so big on making money are not concerned about how it's actually being made.
You know, to me, again, a lot of the business is run by people who don't understand it.
Right.
And that's definitely true of the corporations as they get in. And they don't invest the time or the energy to learn it. So, you know, the simple questions are, why'd you make a movie that loses money?
Right, well.
Well, the same idiot that made the good decision makes the bad decision.
Right.
But the inner workings of how these things operate, how do you build a car and let the car run, people are not trained to do.
Right. Well, you were there at the beginning of VHS and kind of building that out. Was it a completely different world at that point, or is it just a different business, different, more bigger, more pieces?
No, it was the same thing. I don't think, and again, I mean, VHS or video started prior to me.
Right. Well, you kind of created the Disney, cycle.
I took advantage of something that I saw get started in front of me, which was a limited market of selling cassettes. And I felt there was a big business in certain movies to be sold as opposed to rented.
Mm-hmm.
Now you have the whole, you know, business, which is not, you know, just a mishmash. But, you know, how do you package and sell, you know, movies? And which movies are the best sellers? And how do you, you know, create that marketplace? Basically, that's, I think, what, you know, my group did at Disney. But at the time, when I was doing it, I wasn't supervised by anybody. There wasn't anybody saying, oh, that's a good idea, or that's a really, you know, a shitty idea. In fact, the first time we spent money to market, you know, I got everybody coming down on me because it was, well, how come you're spending money on a movie that's not a theatrical?
Right.
It was because there's no reason for anybody to understand why they'd buy something. Right? What's the value of owning?
And do people lose perspective? I mean, as the DVD sell-through kind of became the thing, it seems like the marketing budgets for these movies in DVD became $20-30 million.
Yeah, they were substantial. You know, even substantial when I was, you know, directly supervising, because if you're selling 20 million units, you're bigger than any movie basically,
right,
other than a Titanic. You know, so. Yeah. To spend money to make money is a good thing.
Yeah.
What happens is then it just becomes part of the process. It becomes a sales tool for people to get more DVDs or you know, cassettes or whatever the form it is, Blu-rays, into a store. But are they really selling the specific item? You know, and you can see there's a flood of commercials, and 9 times out of 10 I look at them and go, okay, I don't understand that. Now you are doing what people were afraid I was doing way back when, which is you're just reselling the same thing that's there. You're not selling the value of owning it.
Right. Well, if everything is being marketed, the DVDs are being marketed at $15-20 million a pop, and every movie is being marketed at $50-60 million a pop. Is there, you know, how does an audience find anything in this kind of endless parade of marketing?
Well, I think what happens is they get marketed, and I think it's clear proof, because why do all the bad movies work? So many bad movies work because you get marketed into it because there's noise.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not because, oh, that's an idea that's compelling to me, or that's a movie I might even enjoy. In fact, I might have heard it's not very good, but there's so much pressure on me to go, I go and then I don't like it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that goes on all the time. Do I think that what happens to most of the movies? Most movies, it's sort of like in one ear and out the other. Mm-hmm. If you're not interested in whatever is being sold, the idea of a movie or the idea of a cassette, then you tend to hear the noise and like passes right through and you forget about it.
Right.
So if you look at movie marketing, you know, 4 weeks before a movie's released, nobody knows what the movie is,
mm-hmm.
you know, other than something like a Watchmen, where they don't even know what that is, but they know the name, right? But, you know, a big movie starts getting some pre-sold awareness.
Right.
And then, which is why everybody's going for the pre-sold commodities, and then leading up to the last 4 weeks before a movie, it builds into crescendo.
Right.
And then 3 weeks after a movie's out, people forgotten about it. And then 6 months later, it goes to video and they don't even remember it.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, that's that movie I heard about. And then they don't remember what they heard about it.
So,
would you remarket.
Would you be a proponent of day and date DVD sales? Or
no, because the whole theory of sequential distribution only works on windows, on discrete
right.
and separate times that you can get something. Otherwise, from an economic standpoint, that's complete total disaster.